And could you not see the fear?
No, but...
Why, that ain't right. Why is there a snake in my house?
Just when you think your Friday morning couldn't get any better, any brighter, any breezier, here is Rylan.
Hello.
Hello,
gorgeous. How are you?
I'm really good. It's lovely to have you on the show.
It's lovely to be here. Thank you for having me.
I haven't really... We haven't spoken. I mean, not properly.
We've seen each other.
I've seen you.
We've always gone... You know that showbiz, like,
no, it's one-on-one. We've locked the doors.
This is it, eye
can
to
I say,
eye.
How good you smell.
Thank
is that
you.
Weird to say that to you?
No, well, I own a fragrance company. Like, that's my thing. Everyone knows me for teeth, but everyone that actually knows me, they know me for smell.
But it's warm.
It is. It's oudy.
Yes, it is. But I didn't think I like oud.
Oh, no, I'll make you like oud.
This is a gentle oud.
You love my oud.
Yeah, do you love your oud?
Honestly. I mean, I won't tell you what I normally compare myself to, but yeah, it's not radio friendly.
I love your commitment to things, whether it's turning up at the Deliveroo Awards in a kebab suit.
Every time I've gone to an event and seen Deliveroo, I'm like, when are we working together? Because you owe me money.
Mm-hmm.
I keep your business afloat. Since I've been single, there's jumpers in my oven.
Oh.
Like, that's what I'm like.
Yeah.
And then I turn up and I just see this Donna meat suit and I'm like, what? What is this? And I was like, who signed this?
Did you sign it? Yeah, exactly.
No. And then the next thing I know, I'm wearing a suit made of Donna meat. And that actual day, in the morning, I'm wearing a suit made of Donna meat. In the evening, me and Rick Astley are singing people into the new year. So that was all in one day. A day in the life of Rylan.
I love that. Excited about this new show that's starting.
Crazy.
I know I'm going to be addicted to it.
You will.
It feels like... I'm only going to say Love Island because...
Say what you want.
Because it's, you know, in the sunshine, it's young people.
It is.
Young people, see me showing my age.
Babes, but I'm the same.
But they're doing something.
I keep calling them the kids.
They are.
They're like 10 years younger than me, but I keep calling them the kids. So it's a show called Hot Mess Summer. And what I've done is I've taken 8 of the UK's biggest liabilities.
Great.
And when I say liabilities, I mean horrendous. We're talking, and I love them all, we're talking selfish, we're talking don't remember nights out, ruin nights out for their friend. They are terrible.
Yeah.
They think they're coming to go on a show called Party Summer. They've brought all their nice outfits, their makeup, everything. They walk in one by one and they're like, oh, Rylan from the telly's here, what's going on? And I'm like, guys, welcome to Party Summer.
They
had no
know.
Idea I was there. No, so they walk into this gorgeous like pool bar. It's stunning, really, really glam. And I'm like, guys, welcome. I'm here to introduce you to your fellow partiers, going to have the best night out of your life tonight. Have a great time, and I'll catch up with you tomorrow for all the gossip. So they just think I'm like their big brother, having a bit of fun, or send them all on a night out. They do exactly what we expected them to do.
Is it wild?
Getting off with each other.
No, remember
the next morning.
No.
All like party central, right? I then bring them back to the bar the following day, and I'm like, what's the gossip? What's happened? It's like, oh, you know, that one's got with that one. And I'm like, great, because that's your last night out you're having in a long time. And they're like, what? And I'm like, this is my bar and you're going to be running it. You're not going out no more. No drinking, no this, no that. And they're like, what? Then they find out the reason they're there is because they're fed up mates. They're the ones that's nominated them to be there and none of them knew.
That's
one
so
of them
good.
Tried to walk out, was so annoyed.
Mm-hmm.
It was amazing.
How did you settle on that island? Did you get to go do some good research? And
if you've ever been to Zante as a 34-year-old,
right,
you look at things a lot differently.
Yeah.
I was in a boy band in Ibiza when I was like 20.
Were you?
Yes. So I was in a boy band in Ibiza, but we knew we were there to work. So we partied, but we worked as well. This lot, I don't think I had the confidence that this lot had at that age at all.
Even you, come on.
Even me, I swear to God.
And having come from, as we said, reality TV yourself, obviously you've done so many incredible projects since then. Did you feel that you could offer them any advice? Was there any time or space for that?
I was very lucky that I sort of was bred from reality TV, being a contestant, obviously on The X Factor and then Celebrity Big Brother. But then I worked on Big Brother for 6-7 years. So I've done it from both sides.
Yeah.
So I understand what they're going through. I understand what it takes. And the best piece of advice I always give everyone, and I did it with these guys as well, because they all had their wobbles, was unless you say it or do it, we can't show it. So when people come out of a show and blame the edit or blame it, babe, we can't put words in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So unless you say it or do it,
yes,
we can't show it. That's
yes,
the only thing I ask you to always remember. So when people do trip up, they know it's their own fault because they've said it or they've done it.
Yes.
So that's the one piece of advice I can only give to anyone.
What has been the favourite thing that you've done so far? And don't just say this new TV show.
I would probably say, you know, Big Brother was a massive part of my life.
Yeah.
Obviously, it sort of changed everyone's perception on me. I won it. And then obviously I got to host on it for 6-7 years. So that was a massive, massive part of my life and always will be. I wasn't a TV presenter and I was thrown in at the deep end.
Mm.
And the best place you can learn to be a live presenter is on live TV.
Yeah.
You can do all these courses and stand in your bedroom reading an auto cue. It don't work. You just need to go and do it.
No one is super confident all the time.
And no.
Also, you've been very sweet and honest when you have come back from a break. And, yeah. I remember seeing a lovely Instagram post of yours saying, thank you for bearing with me, yeah. and I'm back. And I read the comments underneath, which
yeah,
is people
lovely.
Just being lovely to you, saying, listen, talent will out. And if you're a nice guy, and I think, especially with live TV, you can't fake that.
No, you can't. And I mean, you can to a certain extent. You know, you can be having a really rough day, and then all of a sudden the teeth, that's why the teeth put in, so it looks like I'm always smiling. But, you know, you can turn that on. But actually, what being a presenter for me is like is when I see that red light go on, whether I'm on TV, radio or whatever, I know I'm Rylan and I've got to be Rylan. Hmm. And it is an escape, I suppose. Like, and that's the only thing I'm confident in. The only thing I'm really confident in life is put me on a TV show, whatever it is, no auto cue, no earpiece, whatever, I'll give you 2 hours and it'll be fine.
Lovely.
And I think people know that. And, you know, when I went through my tough time, when I got quite ill, it was the first time in 10 years at that point that I'd had months off work.
Mm-hmm.
And when I came back, every single job was still there waiting for me. And that was just such a big blessing to me. But I've never treated anyone bad. So I don't care if you're my runner or the head of a channel, I will treat you all the same. I'll make you a coffee. Mm-hmm. Don't worry about it. And, you know, we've worked in this industry a long time now. There aren't a lot of people that are always nice. There's a few idiots out there, let's be honest, we've come across them. And I just learned that very quickly on and was like, I'm never going to be that. Whatever, I could be the biggest star in the world, but I'm never going to be that. And I haven't. I know where I've come from. I'm lucky to do the job I do. I love my job. I love working with different people. And I just want everyone to enjoy it with me, basically.
Love that. And your mum would never forgive you.
Oh, God, I'll never forgive her. She's cost me enough money since she fell over in Marbella, I'll tell you that.
Right?
Oh, she's fine.
Also, amongst all of this, you make time for your passions in life. Taught me to tube stations.
I'm obsessed with trains. I've always been like a train
geek.
I
beautiful old trains, but underground?
Yeah, the underground. I miss getting on the underground.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I'm 20 foot tall. I don't get left alone.
Yeah.
And everyone's lovely, don't
yeah.
get me wrong.
Yeah, yeah,
but
yeah.
It's like, oh, claustrophobic, I'm going to die.
Yeah.
So I don't get on the trains anymore. I thought, well, how can I sort of bring the trains to me? I come from London, but I live in Essex now, and I'm a London boy at heart. So I built my own tube station, my own bus stop. So I've got my own little London at my house.
Are you slightly eccentric?
I'm unwell. But this is what happens when you're single. Start doing things like that to occupy yourself.
That's
so
beautiful.
I've got the Rylan line. I'm currently in the process of trying to buy the Spice Bus from the Spice World film.
Amazing.
Which is on the Isle of Wight. It's a bit of a drama. If you're out there, can you ring me, please? And I'm in the process of getting a tube train.
Presumably you've been to the TfL, like the Transport for London Museum in Covent Garden.
Yes.
Because when you buy a ticket, you can go back as many times as you like in a year. Do you know that?
You're talking to me like I'm mad. Yes. Of course I know this. There's a show that I love, Secrets of the London Underground. And it's presented
I'm not familiar with
well,
it.
Well, you should be. And it's presented by a guy called Tim Dunn. And he said, TfL are doing a podcast. Do you want to come on it?
Mm.
I was like, absolutely, love it. I got on the central line. Guys, man of the people. In the cab, by all means. So I had a private ride. But they took me home from work. So I was in the cab of a central line train, doing the podcast the whole way to Epping. And then we transferred to North Weald and the steam train took me home to Wonga.
Wow.
It's the only way I want to travel.
What a day.
It was amazing. And yeah, I'm trying to get a tube train now. There's one like derelict at Hainault. I'm like, crane it in.
So you live slightly far out of London then, but your house is full of wild animals, it seems.
Right. I don't know what's happened. I'm like Noah without the ark. So everyone knows I've got this pheasant called Patrice that visits me all the time. He's a bit of an internet sensation. I once bought a squirrel picnic table drunk one night and didn't know, and then it turned up and it turned into a thing, and then these squirrels kept visiting me, and then Patrice come along and he's just always been there. So Patrice loves it.
Okay.
Then one day I woke up and I'm walking through my kitchen, thought there was something on the floor. It's a snake.
Is this genuine?
Is it genuine? Could you not see the fear?
No, but...
What? That ain't right. Why is there a snake in my house?
I thought that maybe someone had dropped it there or something.
Who?
I don't, but it's
what
a massive snake.
What's about with a snake?
It's quite a big snake for England.
Yes. But apparently this is like normal. No, it's not. So that's that. Turns out the snake just disappeared. We're like, right, fine. A year later, the snake's in my swimming pool.
Oh.
Then the other day, I opened my front door and a bat flew at me and landed on my hand. And everyone's saying I've got to go and get a rabies shot. A bat! That's not normal behaviour.
No.
So I'm like, now the bats are attacking me, but apparently they're blind. So it's not gone for me, apparently.
Okay, so it's not personal.
Apparently not. They're blind. So how would it know?
I don't know.
But it literally looked at me like, and I was like, no. And I just went, pow, and it flew away. But again, this is the problem with being single. I'm happy on my own, but then you've got no one to... I was like looking in the mirror going, huh, like waiting for myself to reply, like what's going on? It's like no one believes me, but it's all on film. Watch it yourself. I don't know what's wrong. I tracked all these animals. All I want is a nice fella.
Well, go on, mate. You should go on some dates then.
Well, not with them.
No, not with them. Maybe bring them with you.
I think there's laws against them. Like, this is Patrice, my pheasant. Trust me to attract the birds.
Are you looking forward to Eurovision?
I cannot wait for Eurovision. Eurovision in Malmö, in Sweden, 50 years since ABBA won. It's just a dream come true.
Have you got a sniff of whether ABBA will be performing or anything? What's the goss?
I would like to think ABBA will make an appearance. Yeah. I would like to think. I think worst case scenario, we'll just send the holograms. But listen.
Send the holograms.
It's 50 years and it's back in Sweden. I think the guys have got to go, you know what? We do this. So... yeah, fingers crossed. But if not, I'll get up and do a bit of Mamma Mia. We'll be fine.
We're going to read out some of your incredible tweets that we think need a little more context.
Well done.
21st of January, just had a Ribena. Was nice.
Yeah, it was.
Are you on a deal with Ribena or anything?
No, I wouldn't mind one. But no, do you know what? I started thinking about Twitter the other day, or X, whatever it's called now. And I was like, I could literally tweet, I have just found the cure for the worst disease in the world. And it get like 2 likes. And then I just had a Ribena and I was like, well, that was nice. And I thought, I'm going to tweet that. Got like 2,000 likes.
Yeah.
Like that's the world we live in. And I did just have a Ribena and it was nice.
9:06 a.m. 20th of March 2022.
Oh, we're going back now.
Woke up with a chicken select stuck to my face. Morning.
Yeah, I did. It was a good night. I was just gutted I didn't eat them all.
10:28 p.m.
Big brother in here.
24th of July 2022.
Right.
Is it me or are flies nowadays getting more cocky?
They are getting cocky. Do you not think they are? You know, like normally you bat and they go.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like now they're just like, and what? Like they're going to be carrying knives soon or something. Like they're getting cocky. They are cocky. And I'm censoring my language because I don't trust them. I think there's something dodgy about them at the minute.
7:09 a.m.
Early.
23rd of January 2023.
Oh.
Woke up at 5:20. Spent the last hour and a half looking at planes on flight radar and I clearly need to get a life.
What else are you going to do at that time? I'm a bit of a plane geek as well.
Are you?
I've got this thing where my manager, he lives in West London, so he's on the Heathrow flight path, and I'll sit there and I'll be like, that's an A380 British Airways. And he's like, how do you know? And then he'll look on it and it is an A380 British Airways. I'm like, oh, Emirates 737. Like, I'm just weird. I don't know.
My son does the same.
Yeah.
He's 14. He does that.
He's 14.
No, I know.
I'm 35 with a career, but this is how I spend my mornings. Like, this is what I'm saying. This is my life.
I can take you to a place, a little triangle of grass. Maybe you've
near
been
Heathrow.
There. Myrtle Avenue.
Yeah.
Been there.
Big Jet TV.
Yeah.
Babe, I'm well. I've told you. I love it.
I take
the kids watching
there,
it.
And then we've worked out where the local McDonald's is.
Yeah,
so you, then
Andy.
You go and get, yeah, and then you can be back. You can go and get your stuff, be back.
Andy, chicken select.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's happy. Hopefully
you
not on the forehead.
You know Big Jet TV.
Are you mad? I know these things. I am a geek.
Love it.
That is
love
what
it.
I am.
I love it. I love it. Well, that'll be the next TV show.
It will be. Going underground with RYLAN.
Exactly.
We'll do that.
Yeah,
or
exactly.
Going underground or going up high.
Thank you for being on Magic Breakfast.
Thanks for having me,
babes. Absolute joy.
Thank you, gorgeous.